Hello and welcome to the channel. I'm Jay, and recently I picked up a random disc from a charity shop, which at the time I couldn't identify. But for £1.50, which is what was being asked, I thought I'd take it home and do some research. This innocent and small purchase ended up costing me a further £100 when I worked out that the disc was in fact part of the Halo 3 Legendary Edition released back in 2007. I'd always wanted an excuse to buy a Master Chief helmet, and this random purchase had become the excuse to do exactly that. So I picked the helmet up on eBay, sold without the game or discs, and along with my existing copy of Halo 3 on the Xbox 360, I was able to put together a complete set. Having added this awesome piece to my shelf and the mysterious DVD, it got me thinking about which of the mainline Halo games holds up today as the best all-round experience. Now, I'm no Halo expert or die-hard fan. I cannot even say I've played all of the games to completion, but I have owned them all and I've dabbled. So in this video, I want to reflect on what made each game unique in the series and then ultimately try and decide which is best. So let's get started. The Halo series has been the cornerstone in the evolution of first-person shooters, offering rich narratives, innovative gameplay mechanics, and groundbreaking multiplayer experiences. From Halo Combat Evolved right through to Halo Infinite, each title has contributed uniquely to the franchise's legacy. So let's explore what made each game stand out and determine which one rises above the rest. Halo Combat Evolved released in 2001, bringing about, at the time, revolutionary gameplay. Introducing regenerative shields, a two-weapon system, it set a new standard for console shooters and sold a ton of Xbox systems for Microsoft as they entered the gaming market. Halo's story was immersive as it presented a captivating sci-fi narrative with the enigmatic Master Chief and the mysterious Halo ring. The story went on to spawn a series of books and further down the line a TV show too. It benefited from iconic design, combining expansive environments with tight corridors, offering diverse combat scenarios, and it introduced lots of multiplayer fun with local split-screen multiplayer fostering a community of couch competitors. Then we move on to Halo 2 in 2004, also released for the original Xbox. It introduced online multiplayer and pioneered in this space, leveraging Xbox Live to revolutionise online console gaming. Introducing matchmaking and ranking systems, it also introduced dual-wielding weapons, adding depth to combat strategies, allowing players to mix and match their firearms. Then we have the complex narrative, expanding the universe by introducing the Arbiter, offering perspectives from both human and Covenant sides. Although not to everyone's taste, it was a first for its time. And as you might expect of a sequel, it enhanced the audio and visuals, delivering improved graphics and sound design, which enriched the overall experience. Then we move to the next hardware generation, as we get Halo 3 in 2007 for the Xbox 360. This was also my proper entry point, having never owned an original Xbox back in the day. I only experienced Halo 1 and 2 at a friend's house in small doses. What really hooked me in was the story of Halo 3, and the grand scale of this epic conclusion to the original trilogy, delivering huge set pieces and wrapping up key story arcs. I have strong memories of those final levels as the epic soundtrack built during huge firefights. At least they felt huge at the time. It also introduced Forge mode, allowing players to edit and customise multiplayer maps, fostering a creative community. Theatre mode also drove community engagement, as it enabled players to record and replay gameplay, sharing epic moments with their friends across the Xbox Live network. Co-op campaign supported four-player co-op, enhancing the social aspect of the campaign, and I remember spending time with friends who were much better than me, exploring the various levels to discover the hidden skulls and unlock the bonus armour. Finally, the already excellent multiplayer was refined, offering a balanced and competitive multiplayer mode that became an esports staple. It's probably the most time I've ever spent playing PvP shooters. The big team battles with my friends were some of the most fun I had on that console. Then we move on to Halo Reach in 2010, again for the Xbox 360. This was a prequel which focused on Noble Team and the fall of Reach, delivering a poignant and tragic storyline. I've never been a huge fan of prequels in gaming or in movies, so this did make it harder for me to enjoy Halo Reach. I did finish it and acknowledge that some of the things it did added to the series, things like armor abilities, introducing jetpacks and invisibility, which added new layers to gameplay, enhanced character customization, allowing players to personalize their Spartans, and another robust multiplayer mode, adding new game types like invasion and expanded firefight mode. Halo 4 then followed in 2012, which returned us to the Master Chief and followed the conclusion of the original trilogy. Also released on the Xbox 360, this was the first time Halo departed from Bungie, and was this time led by a new developer, 343 Industries, who would bring a fresh art style and narrative focus. Halo 4 explored relationships between Master Chief and Cortana on a deeper level and introduced the Prometheans, a new enemy faction with unique combat challenges. It also offered Spartan Ops, which were episodic co-op missions that extended the campaign's storyline. Halo 5 Guardians in 2015 became the one and only mainline Halo title to be released on the Xbox One generation, and although the story mode was not universally popular, the multiplayer was heralded as the peak of Halo multiplayer at the time. Halo 5 introduced dual protagonists, alternating between Master Chief and Spartan Locke, presenting intersecting narratives. It also brought in new squad mechanics, which introduced squad-based gameplay with command options for team tactics. Warzone mode combined PvP and PvE elements in large-scale multiplayer battles, and we also got enhanced mobility with movement abilities like sprinting, clambering and ground pound, modernising combat dynamics. Then finally we have the most recent title in the series, as at recording, Halo Infinite, released in 2021 for the latest generation of consoles, the Xbox Series S and Series X. This title delivered a real shift in single player and co-op gameplay with open world exploration, transitioning to a semi-open world, offering greater freedom and exploration. We got a new move in the grapple shot, bringing about new gameplay mechanics with the grappling hook. It also was a welcome return to the game's roots, embracing a classic art style and gameplay feel reminiscent of the original trilogy. It also introduced free-to-play multiplayer, making multiplayer accessible to a broader audience with a seasonal content update. It released day and date into Xbox Game Pass, which is how I played it, and although well reviewed, the multiplayer experience felt lacking, with a limited number of maps and environments at launch, meaning games got repetitive very quickly. It also lacked the Forge mode and co-op campaign at launch, which were added later. However, by then a lot of players, myself included, had dropped off by that point. Which is a real shame, as it has the potential to be so much more, and I really hope we'll see new campaign content and new biomes added in the future to bring players like me back for more. So that's the mainline games. I'm not covering things like Halo Wars or mobile experiences here. So which is best? Well, this is just my opinion, and I'd love to hear yours down in the comments. But for me, it's got to be Halo 3. After examining each title's unique contributions, I think Halo 3 emerges as the best overall game in the series, and here's why. First of all, it's the culmination of a legendary saga. Halo 3 successfully concluded the original trilogy's narrative arc, delivering a satisfying end to Master Chief's initial journey. It's always hard to recapture that with any franchise once an original story has been concluded. Look at Gears of War or Mass Effect as examples of post-trilogy sequels that didn't quite hit the heights of its predecessors. Halo 3 also had innovative features. It introduced Forge mode and Theatre mode, which not only enhanced replayability, but also empowered the community to create and share, extending the game's lifespan. It had a really well-balanced multiplayer. Halo 3's multiplayer is often lauded for its perfect blend of accessibility and competitive depth, maintaining a dedicated player base years after release. As can be seen in the popularity of the Master Chief Collection, which gave players access to all of the maps across the original trilogy with the gameplay feel of this title. Halo 3 also had the benefit of the technical advancements leveraging the Xbox 360's capabilities. It offered impressive graphics and physics, creating a memorable set pieces and battles. Finally, its community impact. The game fostered a strong community through its social features, custom games and widespread appeal in esports. I have so many great memories of playing this game back in the day. So much of that was around the multiplayer experience and what it had to offer. I remember playing this on launch day in my apartment back in the day, set up on a projector splashed across my living room wall. It was well in excess of 100 inches and my friends and I played for hours through the campaign and split-screen multiplayer. Good times. So while each Halo game has its strengths, I think Halo 3 stands out for its comprehensive excellence across storytelling, gameplay innovation, multiplayer engagement and lasting legacy. It not only encapsulates the essence of what made the series great, but also set a high bar for future entries in the franchise. So there you go, that's my thoughts on the Halo series and which I think is best. Let me know in the comments if you agree or disagree and why. Please be kind though, this is just one man's opinion. If you disagree, that's fine, we're all entitled to our own opinion. If you haven't already, then please like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video to help others find my content and support the channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.